I am blessed to join, to be joined by a very good friend of mine. Gave me a wonderful time when I visited with him in his home city of Chicago. Pa Kwesi Sam, the president of the Ghana National Council of Chicago. Welcome.
Thane, Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year, Pa. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. We're having a nice weather here in Chicago, so I can't complain too much.
I'm in Houston and I'm having a nice weather. I don't know about you. And well, you're not in jacket, but I presume it's because you're indoors, right? If you step out there, you're gonna need about three jackets put together. Oh, is that right?
Well, fortunately not today. Today is so beautiful. I mean, it's a surprising weather. Have been very nice.
Good.
Yes.
Very good. We're here to talk to you about the Ghanaian community in Chicago. First of all, as you know, Diaspora Network Television is a mouthpiece of the Ghanaian and the African diaspora. And so what we're doing in this campaign is to try and ascertain what the Ghanaian communities look like in the various centers of congregation. And so for Chicago, tell us about the Ghanaian community in Chicago with regards to population, makeup, occupation, and things like that.
Well, yeah, thank you. And thanks to DNT for reaching out to us here in Chicago and to broadcast about Chicago on your network. When it comes to the Ghanaian community here in Chicago, we all know Chicago is the most popular city in Illinois. And so when we talk about the Ghanaian community, we usually say the Ghanaian community in the Chicagoland area. And what it means by that is that it includes people who live in Chicago and then the other suburban neighborhoods, you know, connected to Chicago. So all in all, we estimate about 20,000 Ghanaians, you know, here in Chicago. And of course, we know, you know, Chicago is pretty much about 2.7 million people, but the Ghanaians around the neighborhood, we estimated about 20,000.
Okay. And what's the occupational professional makeup of the Ghanaian community? As you know, each city sort of has its identity with regards to the type of Ghanaians who move there. Is the Ghanaian community reflective of the identity of Chicago?
I think, yeah, the Ghanaian community here in Chicago, you know, when it comes to the occupation, I think, there's a lot of healthcare, you know, people in the healthcare, you know, profession. We have a lot of Ghanaians that work in hotels here in Chicago. We have a lot of Ghanaians who drive taxis. And then we have, you know, the rest of them in pretty much, you know, the corporate world and then the real estate, you know, and a little bit of, I think it's scattered, but mainly hotel workers, healthcare workers, you know, and drivers.
Okay. My research tells me that Chicago is second to New York in being the largest corporate financial center in the United States. Is that accurate?
Yes, that is.
Okay. Okay. So is that reflected within the Ghanaian community? I mean, there are some stockbrokers among us, among you in Chicago.
Well, yes, I know of a few, and like I said, you know, it's kind of scattered, and then we have a few Ghanaians who are in the corporate world, and of course, you know, just like everywhere else, most people in the corporate world, it's hard to find them, you know, knowing the type of work that they do, you know, it's hard to find them. They are usually not too much into the, you know, community, you know, based programs, but then, yeah, I mean, if you go to like some of the offices, or if you need help, you know, stock exchange, you know, with one of these financial groups, then you get to be, you know, introduced to certain Ghanaians that you may not be seeing them during events. But yes, you know, they are all scattered amongst, you know, the corporate world.
Why do you think that is? Because here in Houston also, every once in a while, you run into somebody with a Ghanaian name and you're like, oh, are you a Ghanaian? Oh, yes. And they have a position, some higher up position. What do you think is the reason why the more successful the Ghanaian is, the less likely he or she is to come to Ghanaian events?
Well, yes, Jermaine, that's a good question that we've been asking ourselves, because some of these, you know, people in this corporate world and in this, you know, kind of levels, I won't say, you know, specifically what, you know, I hear from some of them, but I think it is more of them being busy with what they do. And usually, you know, Ghanaians, our events usually runs in the night through the early morning. And most of the time, if some of these people have to go to work or have to do certain things, you know, our timing in terms of programs doesn't favor them. And then, I mean, in the United States, you know, people work, you know, around the clock. And so I would just take it that when they are in these kind of, you know, businesses, you know, their times really don't work with our community events. And so some of them hardly show up unless it's a funeral. Once in a while, you see them doing, you know, funerals and stuff. Or if you invite them for some kind of, you know, fundraising, sometimes you'll be lucky to see them there.
Finally, within the Ghanaian community, I want to touch on the second and third generation. Chicago is one of the oldest Ghanaian communities in the United States. So you guys must have second and third generation that are fairly old right now. Is that correct?
Yeah. Yes, that is very accurate.
We saw some of that when we came to the Ghana Fest. And I think it's pretty impressive what you guys have been able to build up there in Chicago.
Thank you.
Ghana Fest. What's the history of Ghana Fest? It's been very successful over the years. How did it start?
Yeah. Yeah, so like I said, Ghana Fest, you know, Ghanaian community in Chicago, you know, started probably about a little over 50 years ago. And so it started off with a student union, which was helping with a resource, you know, to new immigrants in terms of education, you know, jobs, and a few other, you know, immigration and all that stuff. So in July or summer of 1987, when the community in the Chicagoland area decided to do a Homowo festival, as is being done in Ghana. And so during this Homowo festival, they invited all the Ghanaian community to come. During this festival, a lot of ideas came about, and people decided that it was a successful event, and so why don't we do it every year? And because Homowo is just a one-part festival for just the Gadangbe community, it became important that the whole organizations, be it the Ashanti, Okapimaya, and all that, come together to have one festival. And so the following year, instead of the Homowo Festival, they renamed it the Ghana Festival, which is the Festival of Ghanaians. And so moving forward, you know, all these events that has been done up to today, you will notice that they do the sprinkling of kikule, which symbolizes the Homowo Festival. And because that is the authentic, you know, origination from, you know, the festival itself. And so every year, regardless of what we do, the sprinkling of kikule and all the, you know, Homowo rituals are done, which is part of the activities marking the Ghana Fest itself. So it's been successful. You know, we've done it 31 times, and we are looking forward to do, you know, the 32nd edition come July 2020.
Okay. I'm going to ask you what we can expect from for 2020, but I want to take you back. You say you've been in Chicago for 23 years, and Ghana Fest has been in existence since 1987. So of the 31, you know about 23 of them. Personally, which one would you say is the best of all of them?
Well, that is a hard question to ask, but I can tell you that as a president, as a vice president before I became president, I was the business manager also, and it has been our vision to improve the festival, you know, year after year. I don't want to take credit for what I have done, but I have helped in many of the Ghana Fest. And I think, you know, it's based on the individual, how every individual see it. But people tell me what we did last year was the best. People tell me something that happened in, you know, the 90s was the best. But if you ask me for the past 23 years, all I see is that there has been, you know, an increase, you know, in activities. You know, it's getting better day by day. So we're still not there where we want to.
Okay, I know you're not going to go there, but okay. So then let me ask you this. I know you bring in different acts from Ghana to play. Last year was Samini and Ben Brakom. But which artist Ghana has rocked the Ghana Fest, I mean, better than any of them?
Well, I think our planning got us having Samini perform last year, I think on the Sunday a little late. And I think last year we had Nero X perform. And I think out of all the people that we brought so far, Samini's performance and Nero X performance last year is what I see as, you know, the best on-stage performance.
Very good. So what can we expect this year in July? That's like maybe 7 months away from now.
Well, yes, we having our first meeting in a year next Sunday, and that is when we're going to start laying out all the, you know, plans for 2020 Ghana Fest. And I can tell you that we are looking into it to bring out the best. You know, we always have people, you know, from the community, you know, telling us or, you know, suggesting which artists to bring and all that. Some of them are, you know, we are financially tied up and we not able to bring some of these artists. But as a president, I am doing my best. My business team is doing their best to, you know, try to, you know, bring a really good squad. 2020, especially with the, you know, the return that happened, you know, and beyond the return, we are looking into, you know, bringing more, to, you know, not just Ghanaian artists, but artists from Ghana and artists from here as well. So it is something that, you know, will be hopefully we can achieve it. We want to make 2020.
Talking about the best business. Talking about business, last year, as you know, DNT, we came to cover the event and it was a massive operation for us. We really had a good time. And on our social media network, a lot of the feedback that we received has something to do with the fact that, look, it's great to have this massive cultural event, but what about the business component? As you know, Ghana is really big on investment right now. And I know I've contacted you. We've discussed about the possibility of a business component. What are you planning in that regard?
Well, yes, like I said, we have a proposal on the table to have a business dinner. We've had a couple of them before. And like you said, you know, we have, you know, exporters from Ghana that comes. We have investors here and in Ghana that comes. And it's always an opportunity to also give them, you know, their part to be able to discuss business. So we are looking forward to having another, you know, business event, probably a day before Ghana Fest, you know, so that we can give all the businesses the opportunity, you know, to also discuss. Because, you know, Ghana Fest, we are not looking at just entertaining people. We are looking at having people also take advantage of it and also, you know, move, you know, especially with the government that we have now that is helping to promote, you know, investment within the Ghanaian community and in the diaspora. It will be good for us to also give businessmen, you know, the opportunity to also have a business meeting. So come January, I mean, come this Sunday when we have meetings, all these proposals are going to be considered. And once it's good to go, we will let, you know, the investors and community people who wants to help out with this to move ahead and start the planning. I mean, July is right around the corner, and, you know, we're running a little bit late, but by Sunday we'll be able to hit the ground running by, you know, putting committees together that would, you know, pursue all these avenues in terms of Ghana Fest.
Okay. Okay. Now, back to what we talked about, Chicago being the second largest financial center in the United States. If there was a corporate dinner in Chicago, are you looking at only the Ghanaian community, or can you say that you will be able to attract the larger corporate community to such a dinner?
Well, we've done that before, and I don't think it's a problem. All depends on the planning. When we talk about investment in Ghana, even though we are Ghanaians and this is our territory, usually we are not the ones that are so interested. Usually it's rather, you know, the Americans, you know, that always want the opportunity to go to Ghana and do business. In fact, the president was here, the vice president was here, and we had a lot of African-American community, the American community, that were all interested in doing business in Ghana. So if we have to do this business dinner, our focus will be more of inviting African-Americans and Americans who are interested in actually having, investing in Ghana to be a part. So we won't just limit it to just Ghanaians.
Okay, so that tells me Ghana Fest in 2020 will have two components, the cultural and entertainment component and the business. That falls in line with the tourism ministry and the business development ministry. If they are watching you right now, what would you say to them?
Well, what I want to say to them is that Ghana Fest is the biggest Ghanaian event in the whole diaspora. I mean, there is no argument about that. And I personally think that the tourism industry in Ghana hasn't been supportive enough. And this is something that we, from our part, we have done, you know, on our own shoulders. We don't get any sponsorship from the government of Ghana, even though we know that, you know, the government invests in all those areas. We have been able to do all these things, you know, to this level ourselves. And it is time that the tourism ministry, you know, the chieftaincy ministry, the investment, you know, components, now that we want to attract foreign investors, to take Ghana Fest seriously and, you know, join us. Every year we try, you know, personally, I was in Ghana last year to get them on board. You know, we could only get Ghana Export Promotion Authority to be a part. You know, we didn't get the tourism ministry, the chieftaincy ministry to all join us. But I think it's time that they take us seriously, because it is it's to the advantage of the nation Ghana, and, you know, to the investors both in Ghana and here. So what I will want them is for them to be supportive and actually take it seriously and put it on the agenda for every year. It is a set date, you know, every last Saturday and Sunday of July. And there should be no reason why, you know, they couldn't be part of it, because if we can attract close to 10,000 people every year, they should consider it as the biggest Ghanaian event everywhere in the world besides Ghana.
The Chicago city government or Cook County government, what's your relationship with them?
Well, we have a good relationship with them. And the reason why I would say it's not enough is because a lot of things that we do, they tend to be a part. You know, we have a good partnership with them in terms of finding the places to organize the festival and all that. But their participation, you know, hasn't been encouraging. We have a very large, you know, African American community that are a part of the Ghana Fest. We handle the city, you know, park district in the city. We take it seriously, and Ghana National Council sponsors a few of the events. However, the governors and the mayors and all that, you know, their input in the Ghana Fest, you know, it's okay. It's just not enough. and we will do our best to pursue them at least give us the representation that we need.
Okay. And so given that that you sort of have this relationship with them, and I can say this because there's been past mayors such as Daley attending Ghana First event. So do you think ROPA, for example, if it's being implemented, what kind of support would you expect from either the city government, the Chicago city government, or the Cook County government?
Well, for now, we will expect them to, give us the necessary support. And like I said, just last year, the president of Ghana himself was here, and then the vice president of Ghana was here. The president of Ghana, whilst he was here, was hosted by the mayor. So a lot of discussions went on, and I think we've gotten better than, it used to be. And so if the president or the ROPA is in effect, and we go back to the mayor's office, I'm sure we'll get the necessary cooperation that we need. Now, before I forget, myself and a few African leaders in Chicago, we were actually at the mayor's office to have a roundtable discussion with her, the new mayor, I mean. And we've done round one, and we are round one with her office, and then the round two will be meeting with her physically and discuss, more relationships between herself and the African community as a whole. So we are getting much closer than we used to be.
So which African country has the most of its nationals in Chicago?
Well, I think it's Nigeria, and then Ghana is the next.
Oh, Nigeria got you guys beat over there also?
Yes, yeah. As you know, it's a lot of them everywhere, yes.
Yeah. And so now I know we used to have, African community organization here in Houston. Do you have like the same way that you put the Ghanaian community together under the Ghana National Council? Do you have sort of an organization that brings together the different countries in Chicago as well?
Yes, we do. We have the Organization of African Unions here in Chicago, OAU. And pretty much that was one of the meetings that we have that we brought them together to be able to go, because we don't want to go to the mayor to talk to her as Ghanaians. So it's an all-inclusive African communities coming together to go and have a conversation, and put forward some certain things that we think we are lacking in the city of Chicago. So yes, we have an Organization of African, unity here in Chicago.
What about President Obama? Here he's building his presidential library in Chicago. Do you guys have a relationship with him, given that he is an African?
Well, to be honest with you, Barack Obama, when he became president, mostly was in Washington. We've gotten opportunities to meet with him, here and there. But as a whole, we haven't, done enough to implement something, in terms of Africans or Ghanaians, Barack Obama relationship. But one thing I know is that, as a Ghanaian, usually it hasn't been easy trying to, move up the ladder when it comes to, good things happening in the community. Somehow we tend to always shoot ourselves in the foot when, we are about to, when good things are about to happen to us. And I was making a reference to the land that has been demarcated for the presidential library. At one point in our lives here in Chicago, it was offered to the Ghanaian community to build a Ghana house. And it was a lot of back and forth. And unfortunately, when I think President Clinton tried to get the Olympic Games to come to Chicago, come to the United States, the city put a hold on that whole land. And we never got to, redeem it to do what we needed to do. And then the Barack Obama project came, and they have allotted that land. So, unfortunately, we never got an opportunity to develop that land into a Ghana house. But we haven't given up the fight. We will try as much as we can to build a relationship once the library project is in place.
Ghana is hot right now. So can we expect President Obama to attend the 2020 Ghana Fest?
considered. However, like I said, Ghana National Council is an organization that makes certain decisions. So come Sunday, we'll have our first meeting, and I don't see why or why not they would not allow us to invite, ex-President Obama. I mean, luckily for us, this is his hometown. And so, he will consider a lot of things, and hopefully, we'll definitely, respond positively to our invitation.
Okay, so tell us about your organization then. You've been president for how long now?
Well, I've been president for 3 years. I just got re-elected for another 3 years. So actually my term started officially yesterday.
Okay, very good. And you said, what was the structure? What's the structure of the Ghana National Council of Chicago?
So the structure of the Ghana National Council is such that we have 14 affiliate organizations. And when I mean affiliate organizations, I mean like the Okankwos, Ashantis, the Airway Association, the Northern Union. And then we have a couple of social clubs and investment clubs. So we have 14 of them. So all these 14 comes together to form the Ghana National Council. So we at the Ghana National Council, we are the umbrella organization of all these 14 affiliates. Every affiliate brings 3 members to the central committee. And then I have myself and my executive members who, takes the responsibility of running their organization. But decisions are made, at the council level. Whatever the executives we come up with, we will need the whole central committee to bless it, and then we move on. So it is once we speak, we are the spokes person for the whole Ghanaian community. That is why a lot of things have to go through the Ghana National Council before it is implemented.
Okay.
So as president,
I make certain decisions. Okay.
Go ahead.
Your name, Parkwesi Sam, suggests to me that you're from the coastal area. Is that correct?
Well, yes, it is correct. As we know, culturally, my father is from Cape Coast. And then I pride myself to be more of a Kwapim because my mom is from a Kwapim, a Kropon to be precise.
Okay.
So, yeah, okay. So my name, my Fanti name, I mean, it's mostly a Fanti name, but my mom, from a Kropon, Kwapim. So I am a half Ekropon Kwapim. I am half Fanti.
Okay, so now you know what the follow-up question is. In Ghana, when we have election, tribal differences rear its ugly head loud and clear. Is it the same in Chicago where certain groups don't want to vote for you because you're from here? Do you have that?
Well, I wouldn't necessarily say that it is tribal. I personally, hate to look at things that way. And I can honestly tell you that I hear people say that, my friends are everywhere. And so it doesn't even sound right to say that I'm an MPP person or an NDC person. And people just tend to say that once you are an everywhere, you can be, a trusted MPP person, and the same thing goes the other way. But I have seen the Ghana National Council a non-partisan, and we really haven't done too many tribal, differences as such. I get along with all the Northern Union. I get along with the Husky. I get along with the Ghana. I get along with the Airways. I get along with my own people. So at the Ghana National Council, I think that is something that really hasn't been the biggest deal.
Well, that's interesting, because would you say that Ghana First has played a role? Because for you guys have been together, celebrating Ghana together for such a long time. I suspect that may have played a role in the cohesion that exists between the different tribes in Chicago.
Yes, and I agree with you. And one thing that I never get a chance to mention is that, Ghana First, the beauty of Ghana First also comes from the chieftaincy. And when I say the chieftaincy, most of the organizations have their chiefs and their queen mothers. And they have also done a good job in putting themselves together to form the Chieftaincy Council of Chicago. And so everything that we do, we also get blessings from them. And they are a very organized, council that also deals with you know, the tribal issues, and as such, there hasn't been, you know, problems with, you know, people abandoning Ghana First. Ghana First has been very, you know, strong in terms of organization participation, and so far, you know, as much as I've been in this community, you know, nobody has boycotted Ghana First because of tribal issues, and the tribes have really found a way to put themselves together. And I applaud the chieftaincy for also, you know, putting us on the right path of, you know, peaceful and cohesive planning of the festival.
Very good. Finally, I wanted to tell your viewers the makeup of the Ghanaian community in Chicago in terms of population, profession, and all that stuff. What would you like to tell our viewers about it? Who is the Ghanaian in Chicago? Well,
yes, there's a lot of Ghanaians here. We are looking at least over 20,000 Ghanaians here in the Chicagoland community. And Chicago being the central place, we also have the suburban communities. But when we put it all together, we call ourselves the Chicagoland, Ghanaian community. And mostly, you know, a lot of Ghanaians by our population are in the healthcare, a few in the corporate, you know, a lot of people are in the hotel business, and then the other people are in the cab driving business. So on the whole, I would say that, you know, our statistics splits up between healthcare, corporate, you know, taxi driving, and a lot of hotel workers as well.
Okay, so when you say you're about 20,000 strong, are you including the second and third generation, possibly?
The second and third generation are part mostly because majority of them joins us when we do our Ghana Fest and our council activities and all that. So we don't have the proper data to back this up. But at least from our events and the data we have in the community, we know we could be way more than 20,000, but 20,000 is the base that we know for sure. But like you said, if we have to include, you know, if you look at my executives, you know, most of them were born here. And so if we have to include, you know, the third generation and all that, we'll definitely be getting probably close to 40 to 50,000 for sure.
Okay, so I mean, we're getting to the tail end of this, but really, one of the things that DNT is very interested in is to put a handle on the size of the different communities, because as you know, World Bank just puts out numbers, but their numbers, I don't know where they get them from. We don't know if they get them from people who are there legally or people, we don't know. So an organization like Ghana National Council of Chicago, do you think is within your cards to try and embark on an exercise that gives us a little bit of a close number to the size of the Ghanaian community in Chicago?
It has been the vision, Jermaine. It has been the vision of the Ghana National Council. And as president, I'm not taking that lightly. And our focus is to have, you know, a Ghana House, and we think by having a Ghana House, we'll be able to pursue that as on our agenda to make sure that we find a way to register all Ghanaians in the Chicagoland area. And by doing so, we'll get the correct data, you know, and especially when we have to meet with the mayor, you know, we have to let them know about the size of the Ghanaian community in terms of elections here that we always support. Because we don't have that data, it's hard for us to speak. So it is important for us to get the data of all Ghanaians living in Chicago, and that could happen a long way.
Very good. In ending, what do you want your viewers to know about Chicago that we haven't covered, finally?
Well, Chicago that covered, like I said, in vision one day would to have, you know, Ghana Fest, more of a festival, like, you know, like how they do Essence Festival in New Orleans, you know, how the president of Ghana has been promoting the Year of Return. You know, we also want to use the opportunity to have all Ghanaians put Chicago on their calendar every year, end of July, to come and celebrate Ghana. So it is something that, you know, with enough resources, we'll just want to make it a Ghanaian festival in United States and have, you know, Ghanaians from all over the world, you know, attend it. So it is our focus. It's something that we will champion on. And hopefully 3 years down the line, we'll be able to make that happen.
Paul Kwesi Sam, President of Ghana National Council of Chicago. Thank you for spending time with us. We really appreciate you.
Yes, thank you. And Jermaine, I want to just use this opportunity to thank, you know, DNT for single-handedly, you know, trying to connect, you know, Ghanaians in Ghana and Ghanaians in the diaspora, you know, on a network like this. You know, I wake up every day to find something through DNT, and I think it's encouraging. And hopefully you guys will continue to do such a good job in bridging, you know, the communication gap between Ghanaians abroad and Ghanaians in the motherland. So thank you for doing a good job. You know, we'll do our best to support you guys.
We thank you, and we'll see you in the end of July, and we know we're going to have a good time. Stay blessed.
Definitely. So thank you so much. Thank you, and thank everybody for listening. You're welcome.